Excited about what this team can accomplish this year as I've ever been in the 29 years we've been with the Dallas Cowboys. Now, this has the making of the right stuff out here. Y'all come out here and watch practice and help us figure out which ones are going to beat the New York Giants when we open up. Thank you, guys.
Starts right here in
Oh, the road to the Super Bowl starts right here. Jerry Jones getting the crowd pumped up at the opening ceremonies of training camp. And with that, thanks for joining us. Since 2011, America's team has made a lot of trips out west to start training camp. This year, they kick things off once again in Oxnard, California. Channel 5 Sports is camping with the Cowboys once again. Joel Villanueva joining us live right now on the West Coast. Looking good, Joel.
Hey, what's up, Brennan? Yeah, this is a place where the Cowboys earn their stars every year before the season begins. Of course, the Dallas Cowboys back here in Oxnard. And what's different this year around, their starting quarterback is a guy not named Tony Romo. Instead, what a year a difference makes for Dak Prescott. He definitely earned his star last year, and now he's got a shot to have some major, major star power. Dak Prescott wasn't getting this much love a year ago, but after an impressive season, the rookie rocketed not just to the top of the depth chart, but to the primetime spotlight that comes with being the Cowboys quarterback. In a year's time, he's gone from the new kid in town to the new guy in charge. Dak understands what comes with that.
And everything that I say, people are listening to. Everything I do, they're watching. Not just you guys, but my teammates, the coaches as well. But that's fun to me. That's something that I embrace.
Under his command, the Cowboys offense upped their game, and the team finished 13-3. While other rookies might have cracked under the pressure, Dak's confidence never wavered. Today, Dak was asked if he was ever just a little scared out there.
No, nothing that I can even imagine would or has. And as I said, to me, it's just all about focusing and putting my thoughts and my actions on everything that I can control.
Those around Dak say he's become a special player for this team, one that's become a leader in only his sophomore campaign.
He's just a really good learner. He's someone who listens to what you're saying, and you can just see it. He's trying to eat the words out of your mouth, and he's locked in on what you're saying.
He's taking this situation and run with it, and I like it. I mean, he's poised. He's stay out of trouble for the team.
And at a time when a few Cowboys have had off the field issues, Dak might be exactly what this team needs more of. No drama, just results on the field.
Being the best that I can individually to help other teammates, to help myself, to help this organization. And as I said, the rest will take care of itself.
Yeah, now as good as Dak was last season, he says he feels he can be even better this season. During the offseason, he's worked on a few things, his footwork and his accuracy. But when you throw 23 touchdowns and just 4 interceptions, I would say your accuracy is off to a pretty good start. Much more from Oxnard this week as we continue camping with the Cowboys. Brandon, back to you.
More Cowboys camp news today. The team announcing the release of wide receiver Lucky Whitehead. The news came after police in Virginia announced Whitehead faces misdemeanor petty larceny charges stemming from an arrest in June. After his release, Whitehead has told reporters he was not in Virginia at the time of the arrest. Here's what the Cowboys had to say about the news.
Yeah, in handling the situation, in evaluating it with the authorities there and in talking to him, we just didn't feel like it's in the best interest of the Cowboys to have him with us.
Hopefully he'll learn from this, and hopefully he'll get another opportunity, and he'll know there's a better way to do things.